it's actually not noise.
Seriously. We love you guys to fit. So basically with this one, we're just gonna have some fun and try to take a little bit more questions than we did last time because we kind of ran out of time to take all the questions. So we're gonna try to get through a lot of questions today. Very excited about it. So to start it off, of course, Hillywood style, we're going to show you one of our parodies. So we're gonna take a poll because, you know, since we're adding parodies, it's gonna be a little different now, so we can't show you all of them that are recent. So here are your options. Don't reach in.
Not yet.
This is the first parody we would like to show you is either of these three. The Lord of the Rings parody. Shh. Doctor Who parody. Shh. The Walking Dead parody. Shh.
It's a tough decision.
Okay, raise your hand for the Lord of the Rings.
Woo!
Raise your hand for Dr. Newberry.
Woo!
Raise your hand for The Walking Dead.
Woo!
Okay, Dr. Who?
Open your eyes to what we do, because you're probably like, oh, those are girls up there? What do they do?
Or it's just Dean and Cass are being like me. So if you guys want to line up, we have a mic.
but I haven't seen much from the MCU or any superhero stuff. For you guys, I guess, what are your favorite Marvel movies and what would you consider parodying?
Until it all comes off and you go, there you are, Hillywood. Yeah,
or, you know, something that I can hide from. But with Dean, I was like, it's just his face. And that's why it takes so long. Like, it's a lot of makeup. It's, when I wipe it off, you're like, where did you go? And then the same for Sherlock. It's like that blank face thing, and it's like, oh my gosh. But Sherlock only took 3 hours. So I was really happy Sherlock. We're like, that's easy.
Yeah.
turn it down.
Oh, wait, I'll
just take it out.
Generous.
Just like, oh. So my question for you guys is, what is your favorite thing about cosplay? And why?
Well, for me, I guess I just never really considered it cosplay because we grew up as like, oh, we're gonna be in costume, it's this and that. And for me, cosplay for us is we're gonna take a costume and make a production. So it's exciting for me because I get to become a person with my acting. I didn't experience that as, oh, I just wanna cosplay and spend all this time with the character and just appear like, kudos for you guys, because like, I don't have the energy to do that. I spent all this time, now film me. Like, my little mind. But I think it's really cool, and since I was little, I'm just happy that cosplay isn't looked upon anymore as like, ooh, weirdos. Like, people are actually like commenting on forums, and like, these are awesome, these people are epic. Like, I like that they've accepted our way of life, and I think it's awesome that the Hillywood show like crosses over to all that, and we can like cosplay at cons, even though we're not filming. Like, it's so fun, and I'm like, this is so comfortable. We can just like be ourselves and not have to be all fancy and with heels and makeup. I can just be
I think it's just really fun seeing everyone's creativity and what they choose to be. You know, you're like, oh, you know, that's who's a Bob Ross painter.
Oh, yeah.
Since I went to Bob Ross to like San Diego Comic Con, I was like, yes. Like, it's just so much fun to see creativity and then some of the work that's put into it. Uh-oh.
Jedi Ariel.
First parody of yours that I saw in it.
it was very impressive. Yeah, absolutely. I met them in Spain, and they're like, I just do these like little internet videos. I'm like, let me see it. And they gave me a business card, and I checked it out, and it blew my mind. But I was expecting little internet videos. It was not a little internet video. They didn't know me yet either, so it was...
No, we didn't know you were, like, into cosplay, so it's
like, you didn't know what cosplay was. I'm like, you guys are kind of doing the cosplay
thing. I liked, the first Blade. That was really cool. It was, like, total legit. And I liked my chair for Sherlock. Wearing and hopped in it like a cat. I was just like, but I guess where I want to be.
How about the most expensive prop you've ever had? Baby.
Whoa! I don't consider that a prop.
Because baby's a character.
Yeah!
If you have rhinestones or buttons on the back, we can't stand
it. Don't be against it.
Try the hard way.
So easy to do the old ones because of all the practical effects that they used. Oh, that sucks.
I just like to, that movie was on effects the other day, and I just kept freeze framing it, where his face would just be like making a weird noise. Crazy.
Do you want to hear spare time?
Yeah.
Hi. Out of all of the cosplays you ever did, what was your least favorite?
Mrs. Lovett and Sarah, because of the corsets. That's why I didn't like them at all. Sarah Sanderson's.
Which one is that one? Oh. Smokers. You look great in that.
Should I wear those all the time? Hi. I feel like so hot. You're so amazing. What I do it for.
I'm a great. Well, actually, Rob was Cali C too. But I think the facial here was really hard, because I had a beard, and when I put it on where it felt right, it just looked like a ninja mask. So I had to like pull it down, and then it looked right, but it was in my mouth, and so I couldn't talk or carry on. Okay, yeah, you're right. Beards.
Beards suck.
I mean, give me like 2 years, I can grow my own. See, this—it's not something that I planned. These are part of the masterminds here, and I take honestly too much credit. Even one credit is too much. These girls do everything. You know, they come up with the ideas, they mastermind it, and they ask us if anyone, like for the Supernatural guys, like they asked us if we wanted to do it. We all jumped at it and said yes, and then basically they kind of figure it all out and just come in. They tell us what to do, and then we go.
They don't know what
you're
doing.
We have no idea what we're doing. We have no idea what anything looks like. You know, every creative decision and every prop, every move is put together by these two here. And they're so very specific. You know, we have all the screenshots, we have references, and so it's like we want exactly that, and they know exactly what they want. So it's awesome watching them do their thing. You have my number, so if you ever want me or any of the other guys, or honestly, I'm hoping to get, you know, more random people together, just because it's really fun, and I love the mashing of the fans and the actual people in their shows. So hopefully it works out. So we had Chris.
That's very nice.
Chris,
oh,
and
Chris Rankin from Percy Weasley. Harry Potter was Mycroft, Marshall.
Moffitt, you know, like we have all these people that are starting to notice like just how good the Hillywood show is in terms of production value. And if you really look at it from a technical aspect, like let alone creative, it's better than most movies and TV shows out there. So she's got really nice hair, I suggested shaving it off.
You should be done soon, like, I wonder whether or not people keep adding to the line. I'll cut the line.
With enough coaxing, you might be able to convince Hillary and Hannah to share their home videos from when they were little. Maybe. How tiny are you then?
The same size.
The opening sequences, you mentioned that a little earlier, they're amazing. They look just like the original show.
Yeah.
That's not an easy thing to do. Not an amateur thing. Not an amateur could accomplish. How do you guys do that?
That I take no credit for. I am not talented. Okay. That is an individual named Robert Holtby, and he is in the UK. He's actually been hired for to do some like BBC things. He works on different shows for YouTube. Found his talent, basically said, hey, can you collab? And he's the only person I've ever worked with. And of course, our composer that did, you know, Lord of the Rings, Hocus Pocus, and Sherlock Fury, that when I give him direction, this is how I want it to move, I want the camera to be this scene, that scene, they do it flawlessly. Like, my vision comes to life. So without those guys, I would be like, hey, here's the title card. I couldn't do it without them. So there's individuals like that that are part of the Hillywood show that I think, you know, we always make sure we give credit to. Because my credit is due. Sorry, that wasn't the speed round.
That's a good question.
On average, about how long does it take to film a parody?
Too long. Usually 2 to 3 months, but if it's something big like Supernatural or Sherlock, it can take 4 to 5.
What's the shortest and longest?
Shortest is like a day. We used to do
like to get out.
Oh no, but we filmed it in a day.
A day.
Hobbit parody and the Hunger Games parody filmed in a day. Never again.
Hello. So, have you guys always been dancers, or did you have to learn for the music class?
We started dancing. She was 3, and I was 4.
No, I was. 5-4.
So, that's basically how long we've been dancing. Very long time. So you've been asked, like, if you wanted to be in Supernatural, so if you were given, like, offer, would you go for it?
Say that again,
I did.
You were offered a part in
Supernatural.
Yeah, say yes.
Well, I just hate that show.
Was that you doing an impression of yourself?
Yeah.
Oh my god.
I'm not sure
when they start
playing
Sherlock to
another. But if we did, I know that would be a huge opportunity for us. But of course, we would love to do any sort of side project, Supernatural. That would be amazing. Thank you. Okay, alright. So who's ready to see Sherlock?
With credits, it's 7 minutes. Like on their extra stuff, but they don't play that, so I think it's like 5. That we might want to.
I just feel bad.
What time is it?
It's 5:52.
I feel bad too.
Or sorry, yeah, 4:52. Sorry, not 5.
I was about to say.